studying, tomorrow you also. This is Capeman Primary School. We are having our live math lesson on TV. Thank you for logging in. Boys and girls, I have something with me here while you're standing. I'd like you to identify and tell us what it is. Leslie?
A cube.
That's a cube. First of all, give us the name. You can just give us a name, whatever the description.
That shape is called a rectangular prism.
A rectangular prism. Even if you didn't go that far, just naming it, seeing it, what would you say it is? Yes?
It's a solid shape.
It's a solid shape. It's a box, a solid shape. You were very right. It is a rectangular prism, right?
Yes, ma'am.
How many dimensions has it? Anatida?
A rectangular prism has 3 dimensions.
A rectangular prism has 3 dimensions. We can have them here, which is, namely, together,
the
length, here,
the width,
and here,
the height.
Those are the 3 dimensions. Thank you very much. Take your seats, please.
Thank you.
I have this with me. Tell us where they are, coming from the angle of thinking of the shape or whatever it is. Spell it out. Yes?
It's a cylinder.
Cylindrical in shape. There is a bottom, right? It is cylindrical in shape. And you see that a cylinder. Cylindrical in shape. Right? Emma? Chigume?
It's a sphere.
Say sphere.
Sphere.
Everybody, sphere.
Sphere.
It is spherical in shape. Say that.
It is spherical in shape.
In actual fact, what is it? Maybe you don't know the name. Yes, Leslie?
A globe.
That's a globe. Right? That's a globe. Showing us the whole world. Countries of the whole world, right?
Yes.
So it is spherical in shape. Maybe the last one for me before we develop. We go further. Rock. Seems a bit heavy. Look at the shape. Right? Can you tell us? Itai.
It's a rectangular prism.
Say much more.
It's a rectangular prism.
It's a rectangular prism. It is a rectangular
prism.
Right. Of course, it is a brick. It has been covered, right? You can't guess what it is. I'm holding a brick. In terms of plane shapes and solid shapes, how would you classify this brick? Yes?
Brick is a solid shape.
It is a solid shape, yes. Rectangular prism, right?
Yes.
Made up of what kind of faces? Come on, Ronel.
6 faces.
6 faces, right? Can we count them?
1
There.
2
There.
3
There.
4
There.
5
There.
6
The 6 faces. 6 rectangular faces, giving us a rectangular prism. So the brick is shaped like a rectangular prism. It is a rectangular. The faces are rectangular. Today we are going to learn about shapes. Talk more and get into it. My math guy, I've written on the board. Who can read? Yes, what is that?
Polygons and solid shapes.
Polygons and solid shapes. We had quite a number of solid shapes that we identified, right?
Yes,
right. Right. The word polygon. What do you understand by the word polygon or polygons? Glenn, I haven't heard from you.
Polygon means many sides.
Polygon means many sides. Many sides. You've tried? Who can come to his rescue? Anatina?
Polygon means more than 2 sides.
Right? In other words, we can go by this, let's poly, poly means? Yes?
Many.
Many. And then we have gone. What does it mean? Yes?
Side.
Side. Gone or gone's side. So we are saying shapes with many sides are polygons. In other words, not only many sides, but more than two sides. More than two sides, already it is a polygon. Poly, which means many, gone's sides. Right? Can you give me an example of a polygon, yes?
A triangle.
The triangle. How many sides does a triangle?
Three sides.
Very good. Another one, an example of a polygon. As we are saying, they're two-dimensional. Romeo?
Square.
Speak up, please.
Square.
A square. Right? That's a polygon. Another example? Yes, Amatina?
A rectangle.
If you don't break, just say a rectangle.
A rectangle.
A rectangle.
A rectangle.
Right? A rectangle is a polygon. You just remind yourself, more than two sides, it falls under the class or category of polygons. Poly, which means many, gons, which means sides. These polygons are sometimes known as plane shapes. As plane
shapes.
Yes, we call them plane shapes. To give them names, plane shapes. So it's very easy. For example, here, what is the shape? I just put on the whiteboard. Tadiwa?
That shape is a rectangle.
So it is, who can complete? Yes, Leslie?
A polygon.
Speak up.
A polygon.
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 A polygon. Say it clearly.
A polygon.
Right. It is a plane shape. It is a polygon. A two-dimensional
shape.
Shape. As opposed to the three dimensional shapes. This one has three dimensions and it falls under solid shapes, not plane shapes. Plane shapes are polygons. And it is only when we take those faces from there we make up a solid
shape,
which has how many dimensions? Yes?
Three dimensions.
Right. Open your books or papers that you have. Can you quickly list for me here? Give me about three or four plane shapes and solid shapes. Quickly. Under plane, that is polygons. Please write them. Just write and draw. Under solid, just write, don't draw. Quickly. So that you sure see and understood what we are talking about or we are together. When you're done, you show by putting up your hand. Thank you. speaking? Yes, woman?
For the plane of the square.
For the plane shapes, be very explicit.
For the plane shapes, we have the square.
Yes.
A rectangle.
Yes.
And the pentagon.
Right. Well done. Don't repeat what someone has said. Can you tell on that one?
On the plane shapes, we have the triangle, the circle, and the other ones are going to be holding it.
All right. But please give me the solid as well.
The solid, the pyramid.
Solid shapes, not just a solid.
In the solid shapes, I have the pyramid, the cylinder, the rectangular prism, and the cube.
All right. Tadiba, you have something that has been left out?
On the solid, I have a triangular prism.
Right. Go on, someone. Is that all? All that has been said, is it what you have written down? Really? But you can go on. We have hexagon. It's a plane of plane shape of polygon. How many sides does a hexagon? Yes?
Seven sides.
Seven sides. Right. Now, we could even count. We could even count. Look at me, I'm showing with my finger. Unus.
Unus.
Duo.
Duo.
Tres.
Tres.
Quatua.
Quatua.
Quinquen.
Quinquen.
Sex.
Sex.
Septum.
Septum.
Octon.
Octon.
Novem.
Novem.
Decem.
Decem.
When you speak of a decagon, how many sides is that shape? A decagon. Yes, Anastasia?
A decagon has 10 sides.
Well done. And we can extend to say a period of 10 years? Yes?
A decade.
Yes, it all emanates from that. When we say triangle, tri means? Yes, Tadiwa?
Tri means three.
Tri means three. That's when you can talk of triplets, you can talk of a tricycle, but today we are talking of the shapes. That means a shape with how many sides?
Three sides.
And how many angles? Yes?
Three angles.
Look at the board, boys and girls. Thank you very much for that. We have our plane shape, the polygon, the rectangle, you told us. Something has happened. Can you notice? Something has happened. What has been done? Chigume?
Just cut diagonally.
Has it been cut? Just be clear and explicit. Say what it is.
It was divided diagonally.
Right. A line has been drawn from corner to corner. And what we call that line? Yes, Leslie?
A diagonal
line. So it has been done. We want them to cut through the diagonal line of a plane shape or a polygon, being a rectangle. How many shapes have we come up with? Yes, from inside?
We come up with two shapes.
Two shapes. Can I identify the shapes? Yes, Anutina?
The two shapes are triangles.
Very good. The two shapes are triangles. If I can take you a little bit. That's one when we are finding area of a triangle. The formula is?
Half base times height.
It originated or emanated from there. When we cut it diagonal, we have two halves. But then it gives us two shapes, which are triangles. And look at this triangle. You can identify it somehow. This one. Right, let me put it away. Right. Can you identify this triangle? It's a special name. Yes, Shiguma?
It's a right angled triangle.
A right angled triangle. Say that to Guma.
A right angled triangle.
Why a right angled triangle, boys and girls? Itai?
Because when a vertical line meets with a horizontal line, there's a right angle.
A right angle is formed. And how many degrees? Rumizai?
A right angle is 90 degrees.
So such a special triangle with a right angle in it. It is given a special name, a right angled triangle. Give us some types of triangles that you know. Yes, Romel?
Isosceles triangle.
And say an isosceles triangle.
An isosceles triangle.
triangle.
Write another triangle that you know, Glenn.
Escalene triangle.
Write another one that you know.
An equilateral
triangle. Among those triangles, there is a regular one. Can you pick it up, identify the regular triangle? It's a?
The equilateral triangle,
because all the three sides are?
Equal.
That's why we say regular shapes. When you go to quadrilaterals, uns, duo, tres, quatuor, right? The quadrilaterals, there's a regular shape there. A regular quadrilateral. Chigume?
It's a square.
Why?
Because the sides are equal.
The four sides are?
Equal.
So we talk of regular shapes and irregular
shapes.
Who can tell me the name we give to a shape with eight sides? Yes?
A shape with eight sides, it's an octagon.
An octagon. We said bonus dual transfer to a queen with sex, septum, octo. There's a sea creature that is called an octopus. An
octopus.
How many legs is it? Yes?
Eight legs.
And why I'm saying so, you can always connect. It gives you a clue. It makes you think along those lines so that you remember. Tri, which means three. Quad, it means four. Octo, that's eight, and so on. So, boys and girls, like I said, polygons are plane shapes, and solid shapes are three-dimensional. Polygons or plane shapes are two-dimensional shapes, right?
Yes,
let me show you this. I don't know whether I can see properly. We are talking of the two-dimensional shapes, plane shapes. You can identify the first one is a rhombus.
The first one is a circle.
The circle. The second one across. Anotina.
The second one is a square.
We go like that. The third one, Leslie.
A triangle.
Below we have three-dimensional shapes, which are solid figures or shapes. I showed you. The concrete examples I had when we began the lesson, I did that brick, I did the globe, you managed to identify. So it must be very clear and distinct in your mind, the two-dimensional, the three-dimensional. What happens is, when we take these plane shapes, we can build up a solid shape, which we cannot and give a name, a triangular prism. Just because it has been made up of
triangular faces.
What about when you take square faces and you build up, what do you come up with, Anatina?
You come up with a cube.
With a cube, that's how you identify your solid shapes. But then, nevertheless, if you go further, look at the pyramids in Egypt. The way they are built. They have a square base on the ground, but the faces are, who knows? The faces are, wake up, Glenn?
Triangles.
There we are. Sorry. The solid shapes. All right. I put something on the board. We are having the solid shapes here with us, as opposed to the plane shapes, right?
Yes.
Good. Like I demonstrated on the whiteboard, it's very easy for a plane shape. It is flat. and can be tested. You can do it with a solid shell. If I can show you something from us. Right? A triangular prism, I'm holding. If I have to put it here, it's not like this flat or plane shapes, the polygons. It goes all the way to show that apart from the two dimensions, there is another third dimension. For a brick, you can say the length, the width, and the thickness. For any other shapes, those solid shapes, you can talk of the length, the width, and the height. For a swimming pool, you can talk of the length, the width, the third dimension is, from whom your hands are, Tadiva?
The third dimension is the height.
Yes, when you are in the swimming pool, but when you are standing outside, what do you say?
The depth.
The depth, right. So let's identify now, apart from the plane shapes, the polygons, we are on the solid shapes. This one, the first one, yes, plane?
It's a cube.
It's a cube. Anotina, come and show the class. Any solid shape, come up, please. You're welcome. And you tell me. There you are, stand by the center of the court.
This is a cube.
All right, go on to another one there, because that is the whole lot of solid shapes.
This is a triangular based pyramid.
A triangular based pyramid. What do you understand by that? Triangular based, Italian?
Its base is triangular in shape.
The base is not a square, thank you, my dear.
Thank you.
The base is not a square, it is a triangle. So you go on to say a triangular based pyramid. Apart from that square based pyramid, but all the faces are triangular in
shape.
I once showed you something like this. Do you remember?
Yes.
What was it? Yes.
That shape is called a sphere.
That is a sphere. Like we said, the world is spherical in shape. The world is?
Spherical in shape.
It is shaped like a sphere. What about this one? Some people do confuse this shape. Solid shape on left.
The shape is a cylinder.
That's a cylinder. We can enlighten it to this one, like I told you earlier. And this, I showed you this, you remember? Right. You said it is cylindrical in shape. You look at tins. Of course, some tins are rectangular prism. They appear to be, to have faces which are rectangular. But most of them, they are roundish. So they are cylindrical in shape. Boys and girls, I'd like you to draw for me just about two or three solid shapes and objects. About three, right?
Yes,
you can write the title, go then, after that, roll off, and then you show me solid shapes as well. Allow me to take this opportunity at this point in time, to thank you very much, dear Hackley. Our viewers, you have been with us all the way from the inauguration of this town. I thank you.